Before you install Homebrew, check to see if you have it already installed. Launch Spotlight, search for terminal, and click on it to launch. Type brew space dash dash version and press enter. If you get the homebrew and the version number, you already have it. Otherwise, do the following to install it. There are two parts to this quick tutorial, and you can copy all the commands used here in the description. Open up Safari and go to brew.sh. Under Install Homebrew, you will see the terminal command for the installation. Click on the clipboard just to the right of it to copy it. Go back to terminal, paste the command and press enter. Type your Mac password and press enter to allow the system to run the command. Now press enter to continue. Type your Mac password again and press enter to continue. The first part is now complete. Close the terminal and launch it again. Type brew space dash dash version and press enter. If you get command not found brew, that likely means that the zshell Unix interpreter doesn't see where homebrew is installed. We need to check to see if we have a .zshrc file. A .zshrc is a configuration file for zshell. It doesn't have a name behind the dot because it's a hidden file. Using this file, we can fix the issue. Type cd and press enter to go to your home directory. Then type ls space dash all and press enter to list all the hidden files in your home directory. We do not have a .zshrc file, so we need to create and modify it. If you saw one, we may just need to modify it. The process is the same. Type clear to clear the terminal and press enter. Type nano space .zshrc and press enter. We are opening the nano text editor to edit the .zshrc file. Brew is installed in the path /opt/homebrew/bin. So we need to add this path to this file. To do so, type export space path /opt/homebrew/bin:$path. Now press Ctrl X to save the file and exit. When prompted with save modified buffer, type Y and press enter. This will close the nano text editor. Back in the terminal, continue by typing source space .zshrc and press enter to load the new configuration. Now if you reopen terminal and type brew space dash dash version and press enter, you should see the homebrew version, which means that you have it successfully installed. Like it if you liked it, dislike if you disliked it, and thanks for watching.